Greetings. Once again, I have heard a surprising new claim. You can't tell me which prophet this is, and Isaiah 41 makes it clear by saying a mountain in Arabia. Jesus, A.S., was not born in Arabia, did not stop paganism, but Prophet Mohammed, peace be upon him, was born in Arabia and stopped paganism. Well, let us first identify the multiple individual claims being made in this assertion. You can't tell me which prophet this is, that's one. So it's a prophet. And Isaiah 41 makes it clear by saying a mountain in Arabia. That's claim two. Jesus was not born in Arabia. That's three. Did not stop paganism. That's four. But Prophet Muhammad was born in Arabia. That's five. And stopped paganism. That's six. Central to this claim is, apparently, Isaiah 41, which this Muslim thinks mentions Muhammad. As always, never, never, ever, ever believe what a Muslim says the Bible says. Be a good Berean and read in context what the passage actually says. But I am again excited at hearing something new from Islam that we can examine. Please watch this whole video, as we must read all of Isaiah 41 to prove what it really says. Isaiah 41:1. Coastlands, listen to me in silence, and let the peoples gain new strength. Let them come forward, then let them speak. Let us come together for judgment. This is a general introduction and invitation as God speaks through Prophet Isaiah. Who has aroused one from the east, whom he calls in righteousness to his feet? He delivers up nations before him and subdues kings. He makes them like dust with his sword, as the wind-driven chaff with his bow. Now, Islam will key off of a single word, like the word east, or the phrase from the east. And from there, someone desperately defending Muhammad will imagine this means Muhammad. But is Mecca even east of Jerusalem? Only in the least accurate sense of direction. I found a website that calculates exact great circle directions between cities. Here we are, looking at Jerusalem and Mecca. The direction, or azimuth, from Jerusalem to Mecca is 157.466 degrees. North is 0 degrees. South is 180 degrees. East is 90 degrees. Sailors might call this south-southeast. So the first problem is using a wrong direction as the keyword or linchpin of this error. Who has aroused one from the east whom he calls in righteousness to his feet? But who is even the focus of this verse? Let's examine the pronouns. Who, whom he calls, to his feet. There is no ambiguity. The first three pronouns refer to the individual in charge. This verse and passage is focusing on he who calls one to be at his feet. In this verse alone, it is ambiguous who the rest of the pronouns refer to. He delivers up nations before him and subdues kings. He makes them like dust with his sword, as the wind-driven chaff with his bow. Islam gleefully claims Muhammad is a warlord to try and make this claim. They see the words sword and bow and assume this means Muhammad. But tell a Muslim Muhammad was a violent warlord and they will claim he was a peaceful man. Notice this passage never ever mentions the word prophet or messenger. He pursues them, passing on in safety, by a way he had not been traversing with his feet. Again, the pronouns are legitimately ambiguous. They could either refer to the one, or to he who calls the one to be at his feet. Who has performed and accomplished it? calling forth the generations from the beginning. Here, finally, the context answers the ambiguity of who he is who calls and accomplishes these things. I, the Lord, am the first, and with the last, I am he. The one from the east, or one called from the east, is nothing more than a single phrase. This is an example of what God has done. The one from the east, it simply does not matter who it is. I often say that the Bible, the message of God, is coherent and consistent. Here we see part of the consistent message that Jesus is God. Isaiah 41:4, I, the Lord, this means Yahweh, am the first and with the last. I am he. Yahweh the Lord calls himself the first and the last, the Alpha and Omega. When the Messiah appears to John, he calls himself this same title. Revelation 2:8, to the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these are the words of the first and the last, who died and returned to life. Through Isaiah, Yahweh calls himself the first and the last. This means the first and the last refers to Yahweh God, the first and the last who died and returned to life. The prophets reveal that the first and the last, Yahweh God, would die and be resurrected. The Bible is the truth from beginning to end. You must choose out of a hard heart to reject the message of the prophets. The coastlands have seen and are afraid. The ends of the earth tremble. They have drawn near and have come. Each one helps his neighbor and says to his brother, be strong. So the craftsman encourages the smelter, and he who smooths metal with the hammer encourages him who beats the anvil, saying of the soldering, it is good, and he fastens it with nails, so that it will not totter. But you, Israel, my servant, Jacob whom I have chosen, descendant of Abraham my friend, you whom I have taken from the ends of the earth, and called from its remotest parts, and said to you, you are my servant, I have chosen you and not rejected you. Yahweh God calls the descendants of Abraham his servants. John 15:15. No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not understand what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, because everything I have learned from my Father I have made known to you. I simply submitted this for your consideration. Yeshua, the Messiah, Yahweh in the flesh, was announcing a change in the relationship. You are my servant, I have chosen you and not rejected you. No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not understand what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, because everything I have learned from my Father I have made known to you. Consistent and coherent, if Yeshua is Yahweh come in the flesh. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not anxiously look about you, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, surely I will help you, surely I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Behold, all those who are angered at you will be shamed and dishonored. Those who contend with you will be as nothing and will perish. You will seek those who quarrel with you, but you will not find them. Those who war with you will be as nothing and non-existent. Oh, my Muslim brother and sister, hear what Prophet Isaiah revealed. You who war with Israel will be non-existent. For I am Yahweh, the Lord, your God, who upholds your right hand, who says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Do not fear, you worm Jacob, you men of Israel, I will help you, declares Yahweh the Lord, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. Wow! Yeshua was our Redeemer. Yeshua is the Holy One of Israel. Behold, I have made you a new sharp threshing sledge with double edges. You will thresh the mountains and pulverize them, and will make the hills like chaff. Brother, the Muslim claim mentioned mountains, didn't it? Point number two, and Isaiah 41 makes it clear by saying a mountain in Arabia. You will thresh the mountains and pulverize them, and will make the hills like chaff. I don't think you want to be on or associated with this mountain, brother. You will winnow them, and the wind will carry them away, and the storm will scatter them. But you will rejoice in Yahweh the Lord. You will glory in the Holy One of Israel. The afflicted and needy are seeking water, but there is none, and their tongue is parched with thirst. I, Yahweh, the Lord, will answer them myself. As the God of Israel, I will not forsake them. I will open rivers on the bare heights and springs in the midst of the valleys. I will make the wilderness a pool of water and the dry land fountains of water. I will put the cedar in the wilderness, the acacia and the myrtle and the olive tree. I will place the juniper in the desert, together with the box tree and the cypress, that they may see and recognize and consider and gain insight as well, that the hand of Yahweh, the Lord, has done this, and the Holy One of Israel has created it. All of these things, O Muslim, that God says He will do, He is doing to get your attention. Yahweh is God. That is His name. And Yahweh God is about to mock you who think you know more than Him, that your so-called prophet knows more than Yahweh God. Present your case, the Lord says. Bring forward your strong arguments, the King of Jacob says. Let them bring forth and declare to us what is going to take place. As for the former events, declare what they were, that we may consider them and know their outcome. Or announce to us what is coming. Give us a prophecy, you who claim to be a prophet. Declare the things that are going to come afterward, that we may know that you are gods. Indeed, do good or evil, that we may anxiously look about us and fear altogether. Oh dear, my Muslim brother. In Mohammed's heart, he thought he was a god over you. This shines light on the surah and ayat that mock Muslims as fools. Perhaps I can see where Islam recognizes Muhammad in Isaiah 41. Right here, the false prophets that God is mocking. Behold, you are of no account, and your work amounts to nothing. He who chooses you is an abomination. You, Muhammad, are of no account. He who chooses you is an abomination. Oh my. To choose Muhammad over God, O Muslim, you are an abomination. O Muslim, please read and hear what Prophet Isaiah really said. I have aroused one from the north, and he has come. From the rising of the sun, he will call on my name, and he will come upon the rulers as upon mortar, even as the potter treads clay. Who has declared this from the beginning that we might know? Or from the former times that we may say, he is right? Surely there was no one who declared. Surely there was no one who proclaimed. Surely there was no one who heard your words. No one but the one true living God of Abraham has declared the future. Formerly I said to Zion, Behold, here they are, and to Jerusalem, I will give a messenger of good news. Maybe you think this refers to Mohammed, brother. It does use the word messenger after all, right? Messenger means prophet. But it says messenger of good news. And good news means gospel, which means Injeel. Formerly I said to Zion, Behold, here they are, and to Jerusalem I will give a messenger of good news. This means Jesus, brother, clear and simple. And it cannot possibly mean Muhammad, brother, because this messenger of the good news was sent to Jerusalem. And to Jerusalem I will give a messenger of good news. But when I look, there is no one, and there is no counselor among them, who, if I ask, can give me an answer. Behold, all of them are false. Their works are worthless. Their molten images are wind and emptiness. So, brother, let's look at your claim once again, point by point, now that we know what Isaiah 41 says. You can't tell me which prophet this is, point one. Initially, I did not think this was a reference to a prophet. But Isaiah 41:27 does mention a messenger of good news to Jerusalem. Thank you, brother, for challenging me to read this. We have confirmed Jesus is a prophet to Jerusalem. And confirmed Jesus is Yahweh, the first and the last. And Isaiah 41 makes it clear by seeing a mountain in Arabia. Point two, I did not see a single mention of a mountain in Arabia. Jesus was not born in Arabia, but Prophet Muhammad was born in Arabia. Points three and five. Where on earth do you get this garbage of being born in Arabia, brother? Jesus did not stop paganism. Muhammad did stop paganism. Points four and six. Isaiah 41 makes no mention of paganism or stopping paganism, brother. You can't tell me which prophet this is, and Isaiah 41 makes it clear by saying a mountain in Arabia. Jesus was not born in Arabia, did not stop paganism, but Prophet Muhammad was born in Arabia and stopped paganism. We have just read all of Isaiah 41, and the word Arabia is never once mentioned, nor is being born in Arabia. If you would all remember, never, never, ever, ever accept what a Muslim claims the Bible says. I think I have just served up a good example. At best, a careless claim. At worst, an outright lie from hell, because he has never met someone who cared enough to check. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.